When I think of fate's worse than death, all I can think of is something you said. You said we were golden, bright like the sun.
This is Ward and Al on Canada Talks.
It is, but today is really a Ward-heavy day.
Yeah, it just kind of worked out that way.
Until 3 when Sweet Bon Bon gets here.
Yeah.
Unite against you. But yeah, because, you know, in the last segment, we talked to your high school friend, Anne.
Who's still here. She's still here.
Found out you, you lied a little bit about your past. Tiny bit. Although I'm glad to know that Future Shock was a legitimate thing that other people remember.
Okay, all right.
Because I thought maybe it was like a one day thing and you made it into something. It wasn't.
If I take anything away from this, it's that I had a cool boy band.
I don't. Anne confirmed it was a boy band. She did not confirm it was cool.
I am vindicated.
But also, listeners know that if there is a fancy one on this show, it's you.
Well, yeah. And this is the thing. With the Sharp magazine show on hiatus for the summer until we go into fall, a lot of the fashion guests that I really love to talk about and talk to...
You miss them.
...are coming in here. Yeah.
And you haven't gotten your fancy man clothes talk.
Nope. And Toronto Men's Fashion Week is next week. Starts next week.
Well, so, God, could we get someone in here to talk about men's fashion?
Indeed. We will bring him in right now, as a matter of fact.
All right. Perfect.
Fashion director of Strellson Canada, please welcome David Altow.
Oh, I love the applause. That's great. Thanks. Every time.
Good to see you.
You too. How you doing?
Doing great. And in full disclosure, Strellson has dressed me in the past for several
events.
Because
he doesn't know how to put on pants.
He's got a pretty good sense. He's got it.
Yeah, he put the one leg on first.
Yeah, he gets one leg on first, then the other leg, and he puts a belt on.
Yeah, he's learning. Well, I will say this. Obviously, I am the more... we are meeting for the first time, David, but obviously I am the more casual of the two of us.
Yes, safe to say.
And however, I am also not a man.
Allegedly.
True.
Yeah.
I believe her.
But I will say this. I do enjoy objectifying men. So I'm going to be a big participant in this conversation in terms of what I like to see on a man.
That's great. I'm glad you're here.
Usually she likes to see herself on a man.
Jason Momoa, are you listening? Just in case. He's going to be at Fan Expo. Anyway, just checking.
Okay, so...
Well, thanks for having me. Gotta go.
Thanks for being here. And Strellson is a great men's brand. It's everything from casual wear to formal wear. Everything from suits to sweats. Now...
Do you have sweats?
We do. We have fashion joggers. The jogger's a big trend going forward. So we're going to see it in casual wear. You're going to see it mix into suitings as well.
I found that interesting. And sweats.
What do you mean mix into suitings?
Well, you've got this whole kind of athleisure kind of trend happening. You love that word, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Saw your face. Athleisure. Okay, I hate that word's going to come back and haunt me. I know when I get back to the office, I'm going to go, "What the heck were you talking about?" But really, guys are dressing more casual in the office. And if you're in a creative environment, if you're not Bay Street, you don't have to. If you're not in a blue or gray pinstripe, you can get away with being something a little more fashion and a little more fashion forward. So,
it upscale casual.
Upscale casual. I like it, and it goes right along. You can put that on Monday morning after your Sunday night shave, right? Did we talk? I remember you talked about a shaving on a Sunday night.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing. And then you get right into this. Yeah, you have no idea what we're talking about, do you?
No.
Okay. Anyway, but the suiting doesn't have to be as formal. And you can wear this kind of a suit with a cool sneaker, high top, what have you.
Okay, there's one. I don't want to jump ahead.
Okay.
But
I may have.
We have some bullet points here.
Yes.
And there's one thing, and I think it fits in with what we're talking about, but it causes me great concern.
Mm-hmm.
Drawstring pants with suits. I'm afraid. I don't like the sound of it. I feel like it's a big no.
Well, I've got a suit with drawstring pants, but it's a linen suit.
Yeah. And
when you think of linen pants, a lot of times you think of the drawstring, right?
Yeah, but not with a jacket.
But it's a linen suit, so it's the pants and the jacket.
Yeah, but there shouldn't be a drawstring and then a jacket. What are you, half hobo?
No. But
I don't understand it, and I'm scared of it.
Okay, right. let me calm your nerves.
Okay.
Okay, right. Let me just bring this down a notch, because don't be afraid of fashion.
Okay.
I'm going to write a book.
Okay. I'm not afraid of fashion. I'm afraid of bad fashion.
Okay, this is
you're a fashion phobe, Al.
You are. The whole thing about the drawstring band is it takes it back to that casual element. It makes dressing up a little more fun and sporty. So it's not like taking a fine tailored wool suit fabric and throwing a drawstring in there and a gathered bottom for a jogging bottom on it. It's about taking the fabrics that work with that.
That would be so horrifying.
That would be terrible. I know. I just have this ugly flash in my mind. I have to go. But but the thing is with this is you can take, like, here's a suit that I brought with me. Okay, you guys can see it in here. Your listeners can't see it, but
we'll
sure
take a picture.
We'll take some pictures and we'll tweet them out.
So this fabric is a stretch. It's like a stretch wool. And
is
and
there like Lycra
there
or
is,
something?
There's elastin in this.
Okay,
there's
yeah.
Elastin. So you have this wonderful fabric. It's a cotton, polyamide, and elastin. So it behaves well. It doesn't wrinkle. It's crease resistant. It has this amazing comfort stretch to it. And that's the jacket. The pant is the same fabric. The pant actually has a pleat. It's a shallow, short, single pleat.
Okay.
And I had the same reaction.
Single pleat is the devil in the details there.
That's right. Now, the thing is, everyone's gone into flat front trousers. That's still the main thing. It's flat front all the way.
I don't care for a pleat in a man's pant.
I'll tell you, when the pant is executed well and it's made properly, it's a great fashion look, because it's not a wide leg trouser that has it. It's these slim, narrow, form-fitting suits that have it, and it looks amazing.
But then
what went wrong with pleating was that people went overboard with it. The single pleat is a nice look.
Yeah, but then
I'm going to just look at the pleat on this pants, because what my concern is then, especially with like a straight leg, is that it gets puffy at the top.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't pop out.
Okay.
It's not like those double pleats and triple pleats, and eventually, as Ward was saying, it got out of hand and people looked like you were wearing a kilt.
It's the male version of the mom jean.
It's men's leggings. It could be a megging. I don't know. There we go. So it's something that really, it adds comfort to the wearer, and it adds a sense of casualness and sportiness to the suit. So this is something that, you're not going to wear a brogue shoe. You're not going to wear some cap toe dress shoe high gloss on this. This is going to be strictly cool sneakers. This is going to be, your white Stan Smiths, that type of thing.
I will admit that I do enjoy the suit with sneaker look. Obviously, I'm a casual person, right?
Yeah. So when that's David's look.
Sneakers on right now.
Yeah, I do.
My grandpa used to exclusively wear those sneakers.
They're my favorites.
Yeah, those are actually Al's grandpa's sneakers.
They are.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, Ward let me in.
Yeah. Weird. I will say, when WWE superstar Cesaro was on the show, he was wearing a gray jacket made out of, if not that material, very similar. And he had flown in and like lost his luggage and whatever, but still looked great. Yeah. But then it was also great for him because he had, ridiculously huge biceps.
Right.
And so it worked really well. With the stretch helped him a lot, because or else he would have to get, custom made suits to fit over his arms.
Yeah, that's a problem with a lot of guys. If they work out, if they're bigger, if they're larger in the chest and smaller in the waist, then it's that V shape, and it's hard to buy ready to wear stuff off the rack.
Yeah, that's and all jokes aside, that's actually how I'm built. I'm very broad shouldered.
Yeah,
the broad shoulder man jokes, but I'm broad shouldered, and my body kind of is that V shape, right? And that's an issue I've had.
Or it's a square.
Is that, no, I'm not a square. That's just it. But that's the problem, is that the stuff that I buy off the rack, a lot of times, I have to get tailored, because since my shoulders are broad, I've got to get it. The shoulder's the most important fit on a jacket.
Yeah.
So once I buy a jacket, the shoulders fit, and then it's like, oh, good. The rest of this goes straight down on me. It's a box. Because they assume people that have broad shoulders are going to be like that, are going to be boxier, right?
Yeah.
But we often aren't. So I often have to get my stuff tailored and taken in. And that's a big pain in the ass. I think that's starting to change a little bit, because suits in general and jackets are becoming more slim fit, more V cut.
Yeah, they are. It's slim and form fitting, but not tight. That's the key.
A lot of people are making that mistake.
Yeah, some guys are going into a store and being told that tight is in and slim is in. Yes, slim and modern is where it's at for suits and jackets and pants. But if it's tight, if you drop anything on the floor and you don't want to bend over to pick it up because you're going to split something, then that suit is way too tight. So don't let that happen.
If the material is very taut around the calf,
yes,
it's too tight.
It sometimes.
Oh no.
Yeah, I'm sorry to do this to you, Al. I really am. But it's sometimes if that tighter fit can be comfortable because they're stretching the fabric. One of our best-selling pants, there's a pant we have in the market called the Roost Trouser. It's 96% cotton, 4% elastin, and it's slim on the ankle, or slim at the calf. It slims from the knee down, but it is extremely comfortable. And right. I've got calves. Like, I've got man calves. And
I have man calves,
you
too.
You do? Well, yeah. Okay. So I really don't know what to say to that.
It's an unfortunate aspect, but listen, buying knee-high boots is a nightmare for me. Anyway, how it is.
But with the comfort and the stretch in the fabrics, which we're seeing a lot everywhere from jeans to casual pants into suits, those slimmer cuts can be more comfortable for a lot of guys.
Right.
Yeah, and this suit that you're showing us,
yes,
with the jogger cut, also the cuffs at the bottom are elastic.
Yes. Yeah. It's like a three-level elasticization that happens there. That's an actual word.
I'm gonna go real honest here. Oh, I don't like that cuff.
You don't like this cuff?
No, I don't like that cuff.
What I see with that, this is a suit. First of all, yes, you could. This is a suit that I wouldn't wear as often with a shirt and tie. It's more I would wear with the unbuttoned shirt, but more I'd wear it with a sweater.
A fine knit or a cool t-shirt, something like that, and a really nice fabric. Yeah, absolutely.
And then you're going to wear it with no socks and loafers.
Yeah, that's it.
Ugh. Right.
Yeah.
I'm not a loafer person.
She tells me that a lot.
It's true. He'll be like, do you like my shoes? And I'm like, why do you present me with shoes you know I don't like? See, here's the thing. The cuff kind of narrows in. It is very athletic pant bottom.
Yeah.
Why not just like a straight cuff? Why do we have the elastic in the cuff?
Because it really comes back to the look of the garment. What are you trying to achieve? We're trying to achieve that jogger feel with the dress pant. By having it more straight without elastic, okay, you kind of lose that jogger feel.
Right.
The jogger pants should be at the ankle, it should be snug, comfortable, kind of wear it on the plane, wear it anywhere you want. Mm-hmm. And that's what this is going for. So by having it elasticized and gathered just a bit, it's not a tight, it's not going to cut off circulation, but just by having it like that, it just adds a lot more to the fashion.
Well,
I think next time David comes, he needs to bring a male model.
I can put these on. You want me to put these on?
Yeah, go put it on.
Yeah, can you put those pants on?
When we take a break,
we're going to make you change.
I'll put them on.
Because right now I'm very concerned about the cuff.
When we take a break, he's going to put it on and he'll show you. The thing about it is, one of the reasons I teamed up with Strellson in the first place is because of all the travel I do. And Strellson has always been very travel-minded, right? They have travel suits, actually. Okay. And the thing about this also is that the problem with, say, wearing a regular suit and trying to casual it up, you know, like I'm going to wear a t-shirt with it, or I'm going to wear, like I said, I like to wear a sweater under my suit jacket sometimes. The problem is that when you try to casual something up, where you end up failing is in the cuff, is in the pants leg, right?
Right.
So the reason that you have a suit like this, where it's meant to be a casual suit, you have that, the cuff that way, because then the accent is on the shoes.
Right.
Not on the pants.
Right.
So like, it's almost like the pants are there so you don't notice the pants. You notice the rest of the suit instead.
You just see a great looking outfit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like you're going to notice a man's shoes in this more than you would in a suit where it has the standard cuff with the standard break.
Okay. So then I would caution men to be very careful with their shoes. Ladies look at shoes, and I think men don't realize that sometimes.
But in this suit is where you'll notice those sneakers that you like.
Yeah. That's great.
That's the most important thing to look at. That's when I meet somebody in business, the first thing I look at is their shoes, not their suit.
I've seen guys before and been like, that guy is super hot, and then seen his shoes and gone, no, get out of here.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm not kidding, right? Because it's important. And I think a lot of guys forget about the shoe. They're like, these ones are comfortable and they fit and they're black. They go with everything. No, they don't.
No,
not at all.
And if you wear the same shoes every single day, they probably look worn out and terrible. Yeah.
You got to rotate. You have to have like 4, 5, 6, 12, 13 pairs of shoes in your rotation. And because they will wear out. They'll look like crap after a little while. And you got to keep them shiny
And listen,
actually, here's the thing. You'll probably replace your suits every couple of years. A nice pair of shoes can last you many years.
Yeah.
A pair of brown or black brogues, wingtips, those will last you. Those are classic. They've been around for 60 years.
And they'll be around. And take care of them.
Yeah. Every shade of brown, cappuccino colors, all these light tan shades, sand colors. They're really coming on.
Mm-hmm. You know, for instance, I mean, I am super cash. So today, as always in the summertime, I'm wearing flip-flops. However, I own like 13 pairs of flip-flops.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, my wife too. Yeah.
Trade it up a little bit. I've got a gray purple theme running through my outfit today, so I have bright purple shoes on.
Yeah.
And it looks good. You're working it really well.
I'm really trying to sell that I know something about fashion, because David, I feel like you're looking at me going like, this mess is criticizing my cuffs? What is happening on this show?
What? It's funny, good Ward, you mentioned the travel suit.
Yeah.
And I gotta say, since we introduced that program, the emails we get about travelers, about guys that are in business, they're on a plane, they're in a car, all this stuff. It's really is an amazing program we're not the only ones doing it. I think we're doing it extremely well, but we're not the only ones doing it. But to have, you know, zipper treatments in the pocket to stop things from falling out, a zipper enclosure in the pant pocket and the trousers so your change doesn't fall out. The fabric is water repellent, soil and stain resistant, crease resistant, all this. So it's great. But the one thing I do recommend, and I've done this on a plane a couple of times, is I hate it when I see a guy get onto a plane, even if it's a short flight to Montreal, New York, wherever he's going, and he doesn't take off his suit jacket. That's what really gets me. Or if he's in a car and he's got his suit jacket on. It is one of the best ways to ruin the jacket, because it's pulling against the fabric of the seat and all this. Even with leather seats, it can start to get shiny. So guys, when you're flying, take off your suit jacket. There's a special way to fold it. You can do it so it doesn't crease. I can't show you that. But
I usually can't. Yeah, I usually have to wear it on the plane. And the reason being is a lot of these flights I take now are these little flights where I'm crammed in. It's all one bus. We're all crammed in. There's just nowhere to put it. I can't even sit with it on my lap the whole trip, because now you don't even have room to pull that tray down. I absolutely agree. You know what I mean? I know you should take it off and you should stow it or whatever. But now the way they cram us in on flights, it's hard to do it.
So I thought you only flew executive. That's news to me.
Yeah. Another one of those millionaires doing mid-afternoon radio for kicks.
That's it. the other thing with the travel program is when guys travel, one of the things that I also like to do is I always travel with a jacket. Even if I'm going somewhere on a weekend and I'm not having a meeting until Monday, I always travel with a blazer or something and my jeans or casual pants, just so I know that if I do lose my luggage, if I have to go to a meeting the next day or that afternoon and my luggage is nowhere to be found, I've got a jacket, I can walk into a meeting and feel fine with it. So that's another important travel tip.
That's me. That's everyone. Yeah. That's true. People know that we talk about it on the show here. But one of the reasons I always wear a jacket when I travel. One, when you look nicer, people do actually treat you nicer. Airlines treat you nicer when you're dressed nicely.
Yes.
That's just a fact. Some people may think that's terrible or wrong, whatever, but it's true. So that's one thing. And the other thing is, just so I've kind of got all my bases covered just in case.
It's important. Really is important.
Let's take a quick break, come back and talk a little bit more about this. And you're going to have to try on the suit.
Okay.
So Al can see what we're talking about.
No, I'm not going to make you do that. I'm just going to say I have concerns about the cuffs.
All right. We are speaking to David Altow, Fashion Director of Strellson Canada. This is Ward and Al. We're talking men's fashion. Stick around. We'll be right back. Channel 167, Canada Talks.
Listening to Ward and Al on Canada Talks.
All right, David Strellson.
Oh, David Strellson.
David Altow.
Thank you very much.
From Strellson, Canada.
David Altow, Fashion Director of Strellson, Canada, is with us talking about new fall trends. New fall trends. Everything has to be done early. You know, I know it's not fall yet, but we got to talk fall trends now. I posted a photo last night. I was in the store and the Halloween stuff is out already. Mm. And I'm actually glad, because that's my defense to people who say that the Christmas stuff comes out too early. I try to explain. I go, everything comes out months early. It's not just Christmas. The Easter stuff comes out right after Valentine's Day.
No, for sure. It's still technically summer, but like next week, you're not going to be able to buy any summer clothes. So you better be stocked up.
No, that stuff. It's interesting how the fashion world works. And not just like when you think of fashion, not like Milan or something. I mean, retail.
Yeah.
It's interesting that the summer stuff is on clearance mid-July.
We're shipping parkas, down-filled, waterproof parkas that are good to minus 40 into our stores now. We have, and it's really funny because usually the coats and the outerwear and the heavier sweaters for fall, that's what comes in first and gets sent in. And then all the other categories follow. But it starts very early. We are just wrapping up now our selling season for spring-summer 2016. So just next week, we'll be putting to bed all the retailers' orders for next spring and summer.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, so you already know what's going to be in stores next year.
Yes, I do.
Are you magical?
I can't tell you.
You can see the future.
I can. We don't have a crystal ball, but we do have a very transparent wool suit that we look into once in a while, and it tells us the future.
Nicely done.
Okay, fair.
Thank you.
Fair, yeah.
Well, I want to know about this. When we're going into fall, I've been telling people, it doesn't have to just be for winter. People always go with this for winter.
Wow.
And guys are afraid of this. And I don't know why so many guys are afraid of it. But it's also for fall velvet.
Yes.
Velvet. Yes.
Velvet it's not just for winter anymore. There's also summer velvets, believe it or not. There are very finely cut velvet jackets you can do for summer. But for fall, like September, okay, for parties, for events, things like that, it is a great fabric to have because it's actually light. It has a heavier optic to it. It looks a bit warm, but it can be done very lightweight.
Interesting. Mm.
And I'm happy to see this fall is... one of the colors trending this fall is camel. I'm a fan of camel.
Yes. Yeah, camel. More so in the overcoats and things.
Yeah.
Ooh, I don't think Al agrees.
Al does not like camel.
Yeah,
like
camel. I don't want to shoot this down, guys. But if camel could stop being a color, I'm pro that. I do not care for camel. I don't want to see three-quarter length camel hair coats. Camel jackets.
That's camel. All the rage this fall. That stuff is dead.
Yeah,
seriously.
I know.
Everything in the Strellson collection is camel. We have no other color. For fall. I don't know why, but it's
I'm
camel.
I'm going to be turning down men left and right.
This is the year of the camel.
You may be seeing the wrong camel.
To me, it's this yellowy brown color that I just feel like. And listen, I know you're trying to pretend it's like almost a neutral. I don't like it. I think it's very hard to pull off.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are we done? I just want to jump in here with something. I gotta say.
Okay, I kind of don't like David for his attitude, but I also kind of love him for his attitude.
Yeah,
he just shut me down hard.
Oh yeah, he's not a novice.
No.
Camel.
Here's your 10
Give
bucks word.
Me.
Thanks for the prep. Camel, it can be done any number of ways. There's camel hair, but you can also have that color infused into other fibers. So really when we talk about camel, traditionally the camel hair coat, yes, that's the exclusive, that is the end all be all. But when you look at other fabrics, even in wools, normal wools, you can have that color. If it's softened a bit, if it's almost caramelized, so you have like a vicuna color, which is a little darker, it's a deeper, almost like a golden thing. That's a nice way to do it. Some camels, if a coat is done or a camel color is done too light and too yellow, it doesn't look that great. But when it's darkened a little bit, it can be quite spectacular and quite elegant.
All right,
did I help you there?
You got me.
Oh,
yeah.
Good.
You got me.
That's good.
I'm mostly a fan. I've seen some camel pants. That's not really my thing. I'm a fan of the camel blazer and the camel overcoat.
Yeah.
Top coat.
Yeah, and the camel top coat is iconic. That is the iconic color for a top coat.
I will say this. It's the camel blazer that really gets me mental. I'm going to set wards on fire this year. I will say,
though. She always gives me a hard time when I wear my camel blazer. Yeah.
Well, and then it's like the shoes. He'll go, "Don't you like my blazer?" And I'm like, "You're really just asking for it now." I will say that every other color on this list, I am quite a big fan of, especially on the right people.
I really like the fact that this fall, I'm not really big into the dark orange, but people who can pull it off, I say go for it.
Yes. That's one of the pull-off colors, right? You got to have the right, yeah, right, you got to be the right season.
Yeah, you have to be the right season.
It's a pop color. It's supposed to be an accessory. It's not supposed to be the suit, right? Or the jacket, per se. I actually really like dark violet. I didn't, and I've been kicking myself for this. There was a couple of years ago, I almost got a dark violet velvet blazer, and I didn't, and I wish I had, because it's something you can wear casual or formal.
I wish you had too.
It was nice.
That would have been fodder for a lot of humor. Yeah.
There would have been jokes.
Yeah. Oh yeah, totally. But it was cool. I also like dark olive. You've got that on here.
Yeah.
This is really this season. There's a lot of gray. There's always been gray. Gray is obviously timeless. But this season, I think we're seeing a little more of dark gray and patterns.
Yeah, there's a lot of pattern happening. There's textured fabrics.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
A lot of textures. So it may not have a stripe or a window pane to it, but it's got this kind of 3D effect in the fabric. We're seeing this trend happening a lot in suit jackets or suits and sport jackets, where the weave of the cloth, you can actually feel the texture by looking at it.
Okay, right.
I call it a touch cloth. You don't have to touch it to actually feel it. And just by looking at it, you see highs and lows in the what we call the warp and the weft of the weave. So do you know what that is?
The warp and the weft.
It's the way the fabric is woven. The warp threads go up and down. And the only way I can remember it is the weft goes from weft to right. So
amazing.
Isn't that great? So that's a little
But that's hard to
there.
Say.
It is.
The warp and the weft of the weave.
Warp and the weft.
Warp and the weft of the weave.
So but with those, when those are played with on different extremes, you get these textures and these, like I said, these high lows in the fabric that really give a punch. So if it's something that's just a solid color and there's no pattern to it, no stripe or check, then that 3D fabric adds a nice little touch.
Okay, that's what, because in the notes you gave us too, it said 3D fabric structures, and I was like, I have no idea what that means.
Yeah, you'll know when you see it.
You'll know. No, but this sweater you're wearing right now, that's a 3D fabric structure.
I am wearing, I like to call this my grandpa sweater because it looks like the type of sweater my grandpa, it's freezing in the studio. So I leave this sweater here so that every day when we get to the second hour and I start freezing.
It is cold here. Dave and I are both comfortably wearing jackets.
Yes.
It's a very thick, like cable knit sweater with like a round collar and then toggle buttons. It was a picture, an old grandpa. That's what I'm wearing right now. That's why David's like, no one wants to hear your dumb fashion opinions, Grandpa.
No, but you know what? I'm glad you mentioned that because cable knit sweaters are back as well.
Yes.
For winter.
Yeah, we're seeing the chunkier looking sweaters. The nice thing about them is, again, they don't have to be heavy. You don't have to feel like you're weighted down and you're going to get all schwitzy and everything wearing these things. So you, by having that kind of thicker, chunkier look, it just warms everything up. It really does.
I do enjoy a man in a thick sweater.
There you go.
You know?
See, it's working.
We are speaking to David Altow. He's the fashion director of Strellson Canada, and you can check them out online.
Probably going to hire me as a consultant.
Next week.
Likely.
Yeah, because I have a lot of important opinions on men's fashion.
You can see them at strellson.com and on Twitter, at StrellsonCan. We'll tweet that out, of course. And yes, if you look at some of the photos.
And if you go to our Facebook page, Strellson's website is already up there. You can just click.
Mm-hmm. Right, and if you look at some of the photos of us at some of the events we've been to, I'm often wearing Strellson. Strellson has often provided me with clothes. Thank you very much, David.
It's a pleasure.
I have frequently walked by Strellson.
Yeah.
That's good. You should go in.
I'm a little bit scared.
You know what?
Avenue and
Bloor, right on the corner, is the Strellson, our first flagship. And we have a lot of ladies that actually sometimes wear our product. They will
come
in. There's some cool coats and stuff.
I can see you liking the sweaters there.
Yeah, the sweaters. Yeah. There should be nice sweaters for you, Al.
I do enjoy wearing man sweaters sometimes.
In
the winter, you put on a nice man sweater and legs. Usually what I do is when my brother comes to visit at Christmas and forgets a sweater, I'm like, I have a new sweater for with my leggings. Could just go buy a nice one at Strellson.
In a few weeks, I'm going to go over to the Strellson showroom, and they're going to show me the new fall collection.
Yeah.
No, you're going to get the insider look.
Uh-huh. And you can come with me.
Absolutely.
And maybe I'll buy you a sweater.
Why are you pretending like you would buy me a sweater?
Al? Early Christmas.
Al, I'll invite you.
Thank you, David.
You're welcome.
I would gladly accept your invitation.
Okay.
That's how it's done, Ward.
Sorry.
Sorry, you were going to say something.
Well, I was going to say, I want to talk about, you guys have a new location, don't you, on the West Coast?
Well, that's coming very soon. We have, we've opened a second location here in Toronto, at Bayview Village. And we've just moved our location in that mall to a larger space. And in November, we are opening a flagship, about 2,000 square feet in downtown Vancouver on Alberni Street, right across from the Shangri-La Hotel.
Ooh.
Thurlow and Alberni. And it is our first West Coast flagship. We have distribution with Hudson Bay in 19 locations across the country, and some great independent retailers all across the country, like Outlooks in Victoria, there's Duggars in Halifax. From coast to coast, we've got all these people. So these stores are very exciting for us. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a... If there is, there isn't a Strellson store near you, they are available in the Bay.
Yes. So
it's what I wanted to talk about is the return of a couple of controversial pieces of men's fashion this year. One made its return pretty much last year, but you're going to see it more this year. And I want to know what you two think of it. And that is the turtleneck.
No.
Sorry.
Do we agree? Sorry,
yeah,
I think
it will always be there. The turtleneck will always be there. But we have seen a huge trend moving away from that and into like a zip cardigan with a little baseball collar or a V-neck, crew neck. But the turtleneck has kind of gone under its shell for a little while.
I'll tell you this.
The zip collar sweater is very popular right now.
1% of men and 2% of women can pull off turtlenecks. That's it.
I guess I'm in that 1%, baby.
You are not. There's a picture of you in a turtleneck in your camel hair coat.
Yeah.
I will set you on fire.
Please don't wear that to the showroom next week.
Never!
I'm actually not wearing it with the camel, but that would be good. A nice. That's why you're seeing more of it, is because of things like the return of classics like camel. You're seeing guys wearing black turtlenecks with a camel blazer
don't do it.
Top coat.
Don't do it.
But the nice thing about the crew necks and the V-necks is you get to show off the shirts underneath.
Yes.
Like, Ward's got on this gorgeous, it is a Strellson shirt. It's I almost wore the same shirt today. That would be nice. Your jacket's linen?
Yes.
Okay, so you're fine. You don't have to iron the shirt.
No.
But it's a gorgeous blue and kind of high and low blue and white check. It looks great. So, and now I can't remember what we're talking about.
Turtlenecks?
Turtlenecks, yeah. So you wear that kind of a shirt underneath a crew neck or a V-neck, shows the shirt off. Turtleneck, it's just there.
It's constricting. It always you always look like a villain not in a hot way, in a bad way. I can't with turtlenecks. Unacceptable.
Okay. So there we have.
That's one of the things.
Okay. And the other one, this fall and winter, we're going to see the return of the ascot.
Yes, we are.
What do you think?
Oh,
David?
My God. Are we going to high five again?
No, we're not going to high five again.
Okay.
No. You know what? It will be in fashion in some areas and others not so much. We don't do ascots in our collection.
Because they're dumb.
No.
What do you think? Personally, what do you think of the ascot?
Personally, I'm not an ascot fan.
You're going to high five
again. Yeah.
This is great. No, I'm not an ascot fan. I think, you know what? You can. I love ties.
Yeah.
Guys aren't wearing as many ties these days.
No.
But the ties are amazing.
What do you need
right
the big
now.
Floofy tie?
No, yeah. What's Boo. The big kind of Thurston Howell the Third kind of thing going on? But I think I'm dating myself there. But, you know, it's the ascot.
Gilligan's Warren Island.
Worn right can be a really cool thing.
Yeah.
Maybe tricked up a little bit in a different way, but I think
Small percentage can pull it off and not look. And also, why do you want to look like you're covering up a growth on your neck?
Okay.
Like, do you have a goiter? Do you have a tracheotomy? What is happening on your neck?
Okay, here's the thing about the ascot tie. First of all, the reason that you're seeing it coming back is because men aren't wearing ties. That's why it's coming back, because men aren't wearing ties as much. And they like their collars open, the open collar look.
So they want an uglier tie.
But they want something that's still an accent. They still want something that stands out with their outfit, as opposed to just, like, say, look at Clooney. How many times do you see Clooney just wearing a black suit with a white shirt on the red carpet, right?
Right.
That's what it is. The idea is to add something besides maybe just a pocket square that adds a little accent to the outfit. So the ascot's coming back for that reason. You don't have to actually wear them really puffy and out and up over your neck. There's ways of wearing it where it's flat and tucked down a little more.
Well, also, then you look at the whole phenomenon of scarves, summer scarves.
Yes.
These very lightweight linen, lightweight cotton, lightweight silks that have great flowing, you know, ability to around a suit or jacket, that type of thing.
Well, and see, Ward is really trying to get me on board with this whole ascot thing. And so he was showing me pictures before the show of different men wearing different ascots. And every time I was like, no. And the thought that kept coming in my head is, why not just wear the summer scarf? Well, I like that so much better than puffy.
Yeah. Is that your official statement?
Yeah.
I like that better than
puffy.
That's the technical term.
Yeah.
Here's the interesting thing. I have an ascot. I won't wear it until well into the fall because it is a fall and winter thing. I've seen guys wear it in spring and summer. I don't jibe with that. But I will say, it's a limited accessory.
Yes, it is limited.
It's something I've got one. I'll wear it late in the fall. I've never worn one before, by the way. I've got one. I'm going to try it this year, and we'll see. I like it. But it's a limited like. It's got to be the right outfit. It's got to be the right time of year. It's got to be the right look. And it's got to be
the right event.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
So
I think you could pull it off.
Thank you. Thank you, David.
I applaud you for trying.
Thank you, Al. I mean, I've got a lot of ties. I do tie day Friday, all that stuff. But I tend to be an open collar guy. So that's why I thought I would give it a shot. We'll see. I've also got a couple of turtlenecks, although I like turtlenecks, I'm the same way. I'm like, it's got to be just the right, and not just the right outfit, not right time of year. It's got to be the right kind of turtleneck. Yeah. There's some bad ones out there.
Yeah. I used to love turtlenecks. I used to wear them all the time.
Yeah.
And then my wife kind of would look at me and say, no, you're not going to wear that. Please don't, just find something else. And so that's when, yeah, okay, I know.
No.
But that's what happened. You're ready to jump off.
Like, no, I was just going to say, I firmly support dressing for yourself and all that kind of stuff. But I will say this, that for men who are interested in women, I have yet to meet a woman who is like, yeah, man in a turtleneck, am I right? That's all I'm going to say.
Well, it brings me to a point. If I can bring something up, I had a note here for myself that we're talking about fashion, but a lot of guys out there don't know what to do if you're building your wardrobe. Like we're talking, do I need a turtleneck? Do I need an ascot? You know, what is a guy going to do if he's, you know, going out for interviews, that type of thing? You're entering the business world. Maybe it's a different business. Maybe it's more creative. Maybe it's not 9 to 5 p.m. It's you know, 5 a.m. or 9 p.m. to 5 in the morning. You're doing something in the clubs.
Yeah.
But there are certain things I think that a guy has to have in his wardrobe. There are certain must-haves. There's, you know, you need a great pair of dark blue jeans. You need a great blazer or sport jacket. You need a crisp white shirt. Those are needs. Everything else is want. Everything else is just like, let's work around the base. You know, you need a great suit. But I don't necessarily think you need a black suit. You can do, I think, charcoal gray for your first suit. Guys, if you're looking for your first suit, charcoal grays are fantastic. Everything
super
goes with
versatile.
Gray.
Yeah.
You can wear it to a wedding, a bar mitzvah, anything you want.
Or a deep navy blue.
Deep navy is good, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's funny you say that because I know so many guys that'll talk about, you know, and they're blue-collar guys. They don't ever need to wear a suit. It's very rare they need a suit. And so many times they'll go, oh, I need one suit, so I'm going to get a black one. And I go, actually, black is too harsh. You don't need a black suit. You should get a deep navy or get a dark gray.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
If you're going to have one suit. You're gonna have one, right?
Yeah. And you gotta when to know what not to wear, that type of thing. Is if you're going to an event, a lot of guys don't know what to do if they get an invitation that says black tie welcome or semi-formal or anything like this. And a lot of guys don't know what to do. Whenever I see an invitation or something that says black tie is welcome or formal attire, it is a tux.
And
no hands down, the tuxedo is the most respectful way of dressing to an event for someone. You're showing your highest respect to this person who's throwing the event because you're wearing your best clothes. The tuxedo that's what it was thought of. So by having that, it's not just, if it says business or whatever, you can get away with a black suit or a dressy suit. But I don't want to get in trouble here, but I don't believe in renting tuxes. I think every man should at least own one tux in their wardrobe.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I just say this? Can we, like, could you, as a member of the fashion world, could you guys, like, have a meeting and decide what all the designations on invitations mean? Because it's also confusing for women. Look, even here, smart casual.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Everybody knows what smart casual is.
No,
okay.
I don't know how smart is smart and how casual is casual.
Ward is dressed smart casual today.
Mm-hmm.
I'm smart casual today. Okay,
I'm just casual.
You're cash.
I'm straight up cash.
You're straight up cash. But that works.
Because I bought this shirt at Zellers?
No, it's because you're wearing the grandpa sweater.
Yeah.
But I think you need to know that, you know, smart casual really is is it's just
more
dressed
smart
down.
Than casual.
Yeah, it is. It's not the jogging pant with a blazer. That's a whole different idea altogether.
Yeah.
Smart casual is a really nice shirt, a jacket, or a knit piece with a great pant.
So, for instance, you know, especially around Christmas time, mm-hmm. we get invited to a lot of event parties. And so, like, one was dressed to impress. And I was like, see that? What does that mean? Who am I impressing? And what kind of impression should I make? Because to me, that like I would rather say like semi-formal. I was like, is that what that means?
Dress to impress for me is like, let's step out of the box. Go find something that is ultra sexy, showy, or like for women.
Okay? Yeah.
And something that's going to make people look at you twice. Like, oh, look who's here. Al's here. Oh, really? Oh, wow. That's what that's dress to impress. Okay, for guys, it could be it could be a real cool slim cut suit with a ticket pocket, pick stitching on the lapel, a real cool pattern like a nice wide exploded window pane check on it, and a real bright white pair of sneakers.
Okay, I get it now.
Yeah, it's that simple.
Yeah.
No, that it's not that simple. I had to go to a professional and be like, Gavin, what does this mean?
And sometimes on an invite, very rarely, you might see white tie.
Ooh, I haven't seen white tie. Yeah. I'm not going to the right parties.
You might see white tie.
Yeah, what are you going to P. Diddy's party every year?
It's usually daytime formal. So daytime formal often says white tie.
Yeah.
And that's when you would wear a morning coat, which is very rare.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Please.
Morning coat's a jacket with tails.
So we did get invited to a party last year where the dress code was lumberjack chic.
Yeah,
that's hard to pull off.
That was a confusing one.
We could do that in our collection, actually, I think.
Nice.
I could see that.
Yeah, I think we could do it.
To find out more about Strellson, go to strellson.com or at StrellsonCan on Twitter. And, of course, we'll keep tweeting that out and putting it on Facebook. I was talking about black suits. There's a little trivia for you. We'll see if David knows this. Uh-oh. You know, but Brooks Brothers did not actually even sell a black suit for over 150 years. They used to make, Brooks Brothers has been around for over 200 years. They did make black suits, but they stopped making them in the late 1860s because Abraham Lincoln was assassinated in one.
Oh, really? Ooh. And they haven't made one since?
They only started going back a few years ago.
Wow.
They didn't make them for over 150 years.
So John Wilkes Booth not only killed the president, but he also killed the black suit.
Interestingly enough, he did for a long time. Black suits weren't, if you go into the late 19th century, they weren't popular after Lincoln's assassination.
Weird.
Yeah,
that's,
superstition.
That's something. Holy cow, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the Brooks Brothers only went back a few years ago. By a few years, it may have been 12. It may have been 15, but... Yeah, they didn't sell them for over 150 years.
Wow.
Weird.
There you have it.
Well, it's a good thing they're back because our black suits are amazing.
Yeah.
That shameless plug I had to put in there.
And I will say this. Remember I said that black suits are harsh, and they are. They're seen as, you know, I don't know, glum, you know, gloomy.
Sure.
I will say you can rock a black suit, but this is where the pop colors come in. This is where the deep violet comes in, or the dark orange, or these other things.
Absolutely.
You know, so if you're wearing a black suit, but say you're wearing an ice blue shirt, that's what's going to stand out then is the probably, hopefully the idea is that you stand out. Your silhouette stands out, the sleekness of it. And that ice blue will stand out against the black, not the other way around.
Yeah, absolutely. And the nice thing is when you look at a guy in a suit, when the suit's done up, the top button's done up, if you have a two-button suit, only do up the top button. What drives me crazy is, especially on these sports networks, okay, you see these sportscasters on TV with both buttons done up on their suit. It is so wrong. I just want to, I don't know who their stylists are, and I can't look at it. So just the top button, please, on the suit. But the nice thing is when you're wearing pops of color, that's where people are looking.
Yeah.
They're looking in that V of the jacket, with the opening of the lapel, into your neck area where the color is in your face. That's where all the attention's going. They'll look at your suit when you're walking up to you and say, hey, you look great, nice suit and all that. And then when you're up close and talking, that's where the focus is.
Right.
And so that's why color is so important. It's just, it's amazing what color can do.
Big time.
Listener Doc Canary via Twitter says, you should never wear an ascot unless you're solving mysteries with three friends and a large dog.
Oh, snap!
Good.
That's a good point.
Yeah. That is a good point.
All right. That's a good point.
I like that.
All right. I guess I'll have to solve some mysteries this fall. So now here you go. Here's the outfit. Textured tweed pants, Okay.
Mm-hmm.
White shirt, black velvet jacket, dark navy ascot.
I just threw up in my mouth a bit. there's a high five coming.
Sipping from a brandy snifter.
What color are the tweed pants?
Oh, they're going to be a deep gray.
Deep gray, white shirt, purple velvet. Is that what was it?
No. Black velvet.
Black velvet,
and then an navy ascot.
You know what? And a brandy snifter.
Yeah.
Romeo and Juliet of Churchill on the side?
Yeah.
I like it.
It works.
Yeah, that works for me.
It works. And then while you're planning world domination.
Yes. Yeah. And yeah, eye patch?
Monocle.
Yes. Oh, okay.
Monocle.
That's it.
Okay, there's actually a guy that works at BMV at Young and Eglinton who wears a monocle.
I know. Okay. Yes,
tone it down.
Oh my God. We gotta dress that guy.
David, thanks for being here, buddy.
Hey, it's my pleasure. Thanks for having me. It's great to see you guys.
I'll see you next week at Toronto Men's Fashion Week.
Yes, you will.
All right.
Strellson.com, everybody.
And we'll take a break. Come back and we got Bonnie coming up soon. We got so much to talk about.
I know.
All right.
We're very busy and important. You're listening to Ward Now on SiriusXM Canada Talks, Channel 167.